Liana Daghbashyan, and you're watching the news broadcast on the state television company of Western Armenia. Today's broadcast, the voice of the Youth Council of Western Armenia. Armenia to start winter conscription on December 25. Artsakh Beglaryan as Chief of Staff of Artsakh President's Office. Syria holding exercises in cooperation with Russia in order to defend Tartus naval base. Wheelchairs carved from rocks were found during the excavations in Van. Today is the day of remembrance of Gurgen Yanikyan. The voice of the Youth Council of Western Armenia. Hello, dear Armenians. Today, with this New Year message, I want to address the Armenians of the world on behalf of the Youth Council of Western Armenia. As you know, on September 27, in 2020, the enemy attacked our sacred Artsakh, full of history and culture. Aiming to finally achieve one of his long-standing goals, conquering Artsakh, to exterminate the indigenous Armenian people, to destroy our monasteries, churches, cemeteries and other things that prove the presence of Armenians in those areas, to erase the Armenian history and replace it with their fake history, which happened in Nakhichevan in 2005. The Armenian soldier continued the struggle of his ancestors, fighting like a lion. The struggle for independent and united Armenia stopped the implementation of the enemy's programs. Thousands of Armenians fell in the field of honor, defending the sacred homeland and becoming immortal. Yes, the enemy managed to temporarily occupy a part of our sacred Artsakh. This is a great pain, but this pain will give us power. We want the periods of great victories for the Armenian nation to begin in 2021. We should unite and not to despair. The solution of our national issues lies only in being united, as our history proves, so that we become a great force that the enemy fears. I'd like to mention that one of the enemy's plans is to divide us, to break Armenian unity, and we should not live by the enemy's plan. We must set a goal, rebuild and reunite our divided homeland, Artsakh, Armenia and Western Armenia. Our ancestors have been fighting for thousands of years to achieve our goal. Baruch Shahumyan, Youth Council of Western Armenia. Winter conscription will start on December 25 in Armenia. As reported by Armen Press, the issue is included in the agenda of the December 24 cabinet session. The conscription will take place from December 25, 2020 to March 31, 2021. According to the government's decision, it was decided to demobilize the servicemen who have completed their compulsory military or alternative military service within the framework of the winter conscription of 2020. The president of Artsakh, Arayik Harutyunyan, has signed a decree on appointing Artsakh Beglaryan as chief of staff of the president's office. As reported by Armen Press, the presidential administration of Artsakh informs about this. About 10 Russian warships, Tor and Pantsir air defense systems were deployed during the exercises on defense of the Russian naval base in the Syrian port of Tartus. As Armen Press reports, the commander of the Russian Navy, Dmitry Dobrynin, told, during the exercises, which were attended by more than 500 servicemen, the joint operations of the land forces, navy and air force were improved for the first time. He mentioned that the Russian side took part in the exercises. In particular, caliber cruise missiles, Admiral SM frigate and Vishny Volonchek small missile ship. Four ships were involved by the Syrian navy, Dobrynin said. According to him, Russian and Syrian ships pushed back the conventional drone attack on the Russian logistics point in Tartus, as well as ensured the withdrawal of forces from the enemy. Wheelchairs carved from rocks dating back to the Ararat Kingdom were found during historical excavations in the province of Artsakh in Van, Western Armenia. Van Castle has hosted many civilizations throughout history. Important finds belonging to the Ararat Kingdom were discovered in the Çavuşpete Necropolis and Castle and in Ayanis Castle. Head of the Department of Archaeology of Faculty of Literature in Vensin Channel University, Dr. Rafet Çavuşoğlu, conducted surface surveys near the village of Ulumpamir, situated 30 kilometers from Artsakh province. Architectural remains of different periods, ceramic items, ruined graves, stone carvings were found during the excavations carried out in the Yellow Rocks Hill, examples of which are also located in the fortress of Ararat. Gurgen Yanikyan, Armenian writer and engineer, hero of the Armenian modern armed liberation struggle, witness of the genocide against Armenians. He has studied at Moscow University and was later settled in the United States, where he became known as an English writer and has received the Mark Twain Prize. In 1972, he came from the United States, visited the Martiro Sarian House Museum in Armenia and donated Sarian's painting The Royal Room, which was missing for many years. At the age of 77, he killed the Turkish deputy consul and consul in the United States and demanded justice for the Armenian genocide. He spoke against Turkish denial in court and defended the idea of liberating Western Armenia. He was sentenced to life imprisonment. In 1981, after 8 years in prison, Yanikyan was taken to a closed hospital for visitors, where he died after an illness on March 27, 1984. He was reburied in Yerevan Cemetery on May 5, 2019. He is one of the founders of the Armenian Secret Army for the Liberation of Armenia. I knew that I would not be alone, said Yanikyan. Now I present you a song, Dalvoriki Katrice, by Narek Ensemble. The full version of the song is available in the official website of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.